I am of the view that for us, by for us, I mean in Africa, let me talk for Uganda specifically, there is a chronic lack of data. When we are coming up with, for example, we do not have specific best data for us to come up with evidence-based solution. When we, for example, when government wants to come up with mitigation options to climate change, especially talking about emissions from livestock, we do not have concrete data. How much emissions, how much methane or nitrous oxide is emitted by specific kinds of livestock in specific production systems? So with lack of data, we end up, or policymakers end up guessing the mitigation options. Me, I think there is a need for us to do more research such that we provide evidence. This evidence can then be used by the authorities that be to come up with solutions like mitigation options and the like. So this specific point, I would say we need more, as scientists, to put more, probably look for resources or more funding so we can do specific data to answer some questions. A point in case where we have to report emissions, nationally determined emissions, you know, everyone signed, majority of the countries. But we are basing on IPCC Tier 1 data. And some of those data points are just, I don't want to say guessed, but they may not be specific to our areas. I wish we would get data that speaks to our situations so we know the actual point on ground. Are we really emitting? How much are we emitting? Which system is working better? And how is the productivity in that system vis-a-vis emissions? And how can we help the people? Is it their feed? Is it their breeds? Well, that data, point in time data, would be needed. Yeah, that's what I wanted to say. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. I see Joshua. Any comments? Walter Bathkin from Colombia.
Yeah, I'm having problem. I wrote a couple of sticky notes, but they're not showing up. I think that a couple of general comments. One is that I believe that we need to ensure that we differentiate what livestock production system we're referring to. And it's very common that, you know, especially not people not from the area of livestock production, but people talk about livestock production system as if it was homogeneous. Right. And so, you know, whatever we propose as research actions and needs, the first thing I would say is we need to differentiate. Are we talking about a system that destroys a tropical forest and then plants a pasture and then starts producing livestock? Are we talking about grazing systems and natural ecosystems that, you know, may even help to preserve those ecosystems? Are we talking about industrial production? And so, you know, in my view, personal opinion, in priority systems, one is those. I believe that, you know, 20% of the land is now grasslands, and you know, research on the sustainability of production systems in those conditions, mainly because these are areas that are not competing to produce food for human. You know, these are areas that where animals are transforming something that is not edible for humans into something that is nutrient rich. Mm-hmm. And the other one is the pastoralist systems. The main reason is that that's probably where some of the most vulnerable people involved in livestock production are involved. So those are my very general comments.
You know, thank you, Walter, because one of the challenges that we have as the author team is to try to distill exactly what you just tried to do. What are the priority systems? And we are leaving that pretty broad as a starting point. You're absolutely right. We have to narrow this down. You can't just say livestock production system, because that's unhelpful. There's no point of intervention there. So talking about which ones, and you've just identified two for us that we could then go look at and work on. So that is exactly the kind of input we're looking for here.
Yes, and I see from the post-its that many people have already mentioned poultry production, for example, in some situations,
yep.
Small ruminant production for vulnerable pastoralists. What else? There is also something around grazing systems, focusing on key systems with serious constraints. Those seem to be important. Dairy as a quick win opportunity. I think that dairy has received a lot of attention in the past, especially in low and middle income countries, and at least from the ruminant sector, is one of the stories of success. The key is obviously then the feed provisioning and so on for this. And I see that Ahmed has the hand up.
Thank you, Mario. A couple of things. I have not heard anything about fisheries from the fisheries sector.
Good point.
In this discussion, and we have been focusing on large and small livestock production or land animals. A lot of the challenges that we talked about here, or I see it in the sticky note, are similar to the fisheries or the aquaculture side. I would want to bring to potential discussion the importance of a sustainable source for aquaculture / fisheries or aquaculture feed in a sustainable food system in order to advance productivity and reduce the wastage. What I have noticed, I'm not a fishery expert or aquaculture expert, but from my visits with our field missions, what I noticed, some of the challenges are feed source. In other words, they're low quality and or dependence on import of feed. A sustainable production of feed using animal source protein or circular economy, as some of the sticky note I see it here, could be a solution for that issue. I would love to hear any other thought here. Thank you.
That's a really good intervention. Thanks a lot. I can see that Susu and Alamu want also to make comments, one after the other, and then we'll need to start wrapping up the contributions. I really think that this has been short, but it's provided at least some initial entry points into this. You are all starting to get warming up with ideas and so on. But Susu, please go ahead. Okay, or Aderonke?
All right. Can you hear me?
Yes,
yes, we can hear you.
Well done, everyone. Being an academic person in educational and institution, I will want to refer to the area of research as the priority system that I want to talk about now. And I know Chinee has mentioned, I can't remember the name, has talked about the research and not having, there's no available data that one can work with. So a priority system that I think one we can work on is funding of research that address problems that are on the field. Okay, the production system, the practices that the farmers are carrying on the field, and carrying out research on how we can solve the problem that exists on the field. And also bridging the information gap between the researchers and the people on the field. there happens to be a kind of gap between the researchers and then the people on the field. It's one thing to carry out research that solves, that tackles problems that exist on the field. It's another thing to disseminate the information or the solution that one is able to arrive at when you carry out research and make them to know. So a leverage point that I think we can leverage on is working with existing associations of farmers of different, I'm referring to fishery and aquaculture right now. Not about other livestock, I'm talking about aquaculture right now. Working with the existing association of different farmers in different regions, most especially in Africa, and then letting them know the findings, the solutions that we've been able to come up with in the area of research. So that is my own contribution.
Okay, thank you. So,
and Mario, I know we have 16 seconds till we're going back to the main room.
Yes, exactly. So, Juliet, can you, would you like to present in the a summary in the plenary now?
Okay, that's fine.
Okay, great.
Folks, super, well, everyone who's in the room, I'm going to strongly suggest if you ignore the pop-up that just came up, you will automatically be brought back to the main room. They suggest you do this only because if you hit the wrong button, you can find yourself kicked out of the meeting entirely. So you may want to wait in 1 minute and 30 seconds. They will automatically move us back.
Yeah.